Hello and welcome to Tutorials Point. Today in conversion rate optimization, we'll discuss an important topic. The topic is how to become a good CRO strategist. What are the key ingredients of a good CRO strategist? The skills required, the expertise required, and what are the tips that you can think of using and implementing to become a good CRO strategist? Let's get started with it. Who is a good CRO strategist? What are the skills they need actually in becoming a good CRO strategist? A good CRO strategist must possess the necessary skills, experience, expertise, and exposure in CRO techniques. The first and foremost point, the focal point, he should have or she should have excellent knowledge in building, using, and implementing CRO techniques. The experience, the exposure, and the expertise is extremely important to become a good CRO strategist. Who has the credentials and the past performance to show? Credentials, past performance, testimonials play a very important role in actually persuading and convincing a client or a customer. Without the past performance and the credentials, it is extremely difficult to convince a customer. A customer, no matter how naive they may be, or no matter whether they have any knowledge as far as conversion rate optimization is concerned or not, they will be asking you the most important question: who are your clients? What is your past performance? Show us your past performance. Show us your credentials. Show us your testimonials. And this information is crucial actually in actually helping you in getting more and more customers, because customers believe at the end of the day in the past performance. Who is meticulous in planning and executing strategies? Meticulous planning and executing strategies is extremely important. Extremely important point that you have to be very, very meticulous in your planning and execution. Who listens and understands the customer needs, goals, and objectives? When you are interacting, communicating, and engaging with your clients, customers, it is extremely important you listen to them. You listen them completely, what they are saying, how they are saying, what are their websites, what are their blogs, what are their landing pages, how they look like, and what are their pain points, what are the issues, concerns, and challenges as far as their customers are concerned. These key importance are very, very important. You need to understand their goals and objectives, what they want to achieve. Unless and until you get this information, you will be not in a much better position to actually help them in conversion rate optimization. Who works in adding value to the customers? Adding value to the customers is key to get you more and more customers. One happy customer, one satisfied customer will get you lot many referrals, and those referrals are actually the word of mouth that spreads around that you are a good strategist. And the moment you actually add value to your customers, help them grow their business, your business as a good CRO strategist will do wonders for you. What are the responsibilities of a good CRO strategist? Communicate effectively with the customers is extremely important. Your communication skills matter at the end of the day. How good you are actually in communicating with your customers, whether understanding their requirements, explaining their requirements, the documentation that you do, and how actually you are going to implement the series of changes that may be required for their websites and the landing pages. Effective communication is the driving force in driving a customer. Review analysis websites and the landing pages. You should be extremely good in actually reviewing, analyzing the websites and the landing pages of your customers, so that you will be in a much better position to understand what is working and what is not working. Document issues, concerns, challenges, gaps, if any. All the issues, concerns, and challenges of your customers, websites, blogs, or landing pages need to be reviewed and analyzed, and they need to be documented. Documentation actually plays a very important role in actually convincing a customer, and you can tell them clearly, see, these are the issues, concerns, and challenges that are existing on your website, and these are the reasons why the conversions is not happening, and this is what need to be done. The documentation has to spell out everything clearly. List out the issues, concerns, challenges, gaps, if any, then what are the recommendations that you are actually submitting them that need to be implemented, and how these recommendations will be implemented by you. this part, the entire documentation that you do for your customers. Build effective CRO strategy roadmap implementation plan. Effective roadmap implementation part is the second part after you submit the first document, which are the issues concerns. Once you do that, you actually build a roadmap implementation plan day by day, week by week, month by month. And that document has to clearly spell out all the techniques that you need to actually going to implement on the website and the landing pages of your customers. Then you have built consensus with customers and all stakeholders. After identifying the issues and concerns and the challenges of the website of your customer, you are actually going to recommend certain changes, improvements and enhancements. And those recommendations actually have to be taken into consideration with the kind of requirements that the customer has and all stakeholders, whether they have a management team or the key decision makers. You need to actually explain them what are your recommendations and what you will be implementing and what will be the impact of those recommendations. And you need to take them everybody on board. You need to explain them and take their approval. Without taking their approval, you cannot do any changes to their website, and that should not be done actually. Track, measure, analyze reports and everything. After actually you complete all the recommendation, challenges and implementation, you actually need to track those changes, track, measure those changes through the analytical information that is provided. This is the traffic that the customer was getting before you actually implemented those changes, and this is actually the traffic that you are actually generating after you make the changes. These two need to be clearly identified and told to the customer, see, because of the changes that we have done for the website and the landing pages, this is the additional traffic that we are getting and this is the more traffic that we are getting, and analytical information reports has to be submitted to your client and customers. Then after you actually do the analysis through the analytical information, after measuring the analytical information, you go on doing the continuous improvements. In CRO, continuous improvements plays a very important and crucial role, and it is actually a part and parcel of the integral part of the CRO strategy. Continuous improvement actually keeps on growing your traffic to your website, that leads to more and more conversions happening. And continuous process has to be a consistent and continuous process, and this actually need to be informed to the customer and the client. Then you have got the conversions happening. When you do the continuous improvement, then you actually you build a customer base for your clients and customers, and these are precisely what the responsibilities of a good CRO strategy is. Then the skills of a good CRO strategy. You should preferably coming from a digital marketing background. It will help you immensely if you come from a digital marketing background. If you have digital marketing knowledge, that helps you immensely. Now, what are the key elements of a digital marketing strategies? They should be knowing search engine optimization. They should be knowing PPC campaigns, search engine marketing, social media optimization, online reputation management, content marketing, so on and so forth. These are all the parts of digital marketing. If you know the digital marketing skills, if you have the digital marketing skills, that will help you immensely in doing conversion rate optimization effectively. Excellent knowledge in web designing and copywriting. A website or a landing page, a blog, it consists of the design and the content associated with it. Good knowledge in content writing, copywriting and web designing, basic HTML at least, plays a very important role in actually analyzing your website or the customer's website, so that you can actually come to a conclusion with regard to the issues, concerns and challenges existing on your website. Good knowledge in web designing and copywriting plays an important role and an essential part of it. In-depth knowledge in digital and web analytics. Without web and digital analytics, you cannot be a good CRO strategist, because digital and web analytics are the backbone of conversion rate optimization. You should have in-depth knowledge in digital and web analytics so that you can track, measure, analyze the reports generated through analytics, because they actually tell you what is working and what is not working as far as the websites and landing pages are concerned. And eye for detail, meticulous planning and eye for detail are extremely important in helping your customer get good conversions. Good research skills. Extremely important. When you are actually working for a client with their website, you actually need to do a lot of research in terms of competitor analysis, in terms of keyword research. And these research skills will help you in understanding the kind of competition that is existing out there in the market for your customer, so that you can analyze those information and what the competitors are doing, how they are doing, what are the keyword working, what are the keywords not working. These research skills actually help you in doing more and more and better work. Familiar with all the current trends and the best practices, you need to be consistently, continuously updating your knowledge with the best practices that are implemented as far as conversion rate optimization strategies is concerned. You need to be actually in consonance with the best practices that are implemented. Keep on reading, keep on reviewing, listen to the experts, see the videos, read the content, visit the website, subscribe to the best blogs, newsletters, so that you can keep on improving your knowledge. Extremely important. You cannot implement outdated techniques for your customers. Excellent written, verbal and persuasive skills. You need to actually be excellent in written and verbal communication as well as persuasive skills. Persuasive skills will help you in actually making your point of view to the customer, and verbal skills and communication skills, actually written skills, help you in analyzing the kind of content that is existing on your website. Be patient and pay attention to details. Conversion rate optimization is not going to happen overnight. It will never happen overnight. It is a long drawn process, a continuous and a consistent process. You have to be patient. You have to be persuasive. You have to actually keep on improving, continuous improvement, so that you can drive conversions. It will not happen overnight. It is a continuous and a consistent process. It will take a long time for the techniques to be implemented and they actually drive conversions for your customers. And the tips that you can think of implementing for a good strategy. Always be honest and truthful to the customers. Never mislead your customer. Never ever do that. Be honest and be truthful. Make sure that you know you tell the truth to the customer with regard to the websites, blogs. Research, analyze the customer's business thoroughly. When you are interacting, communicating and engaging with your customers, do the research on their business, do the research on the website, the landing pages and the blogs. Make sure that you have the complete information when you actually sit face to face with your customer in discussing about implementation of CRO for their website. Raise issues, concerns on the website launches clearly. Extremely important. Whatever the issues, concerns, challenges that are existing on the website, you tell them truthfully, honestly and clearly to your customer. See, these are the problems that are associated with the website. These are the reasons why the traffic is not coming to the website. And these are the reasons, even though if the traffic is coming to the website, but the conversions are not happening. You have to spell them out clearly, lucidly and clearly to your customers. Clearly explain the customers on the roadmap ahead. What is the roadmap you are building? What are the changes that you are recommending? All the recommendations have to be clearly told to the customer and take their approval before implementing them on their websites. Build a CRO strategy aligned with the customer's business goals. The CRO strategy should be centered, it should be focused on the business goals and the business objectives of your customers. It should be centered around them, the kind of traffic that you will drive to the website and the conversion that may happen related to their business. Take customers on board about the changes. Every single change that you do on their landing pages, on their website, whether in terms of user experience, interface or the content, they have to be informed to your customer before you do the changes. Always keep customers informed on the developments. Each and every development that is happening in terms of the changes, in terms of improvements, in terms of enhancements, and in terms of the analytical information, they need to be updated to your client with your weekly or a bi-monthly or a monthly reports that you actually submit to your clients. Submit reports periodically. You set a timeline, what is the reports that you will be submitting at what time. It could be a monthly report, it could be a weekly report, it could be a fortnightly report. All the reports that actually, what are the contents of that report, this need to be spelled out and submit your reports periodically to your customer so that the customer is well informed about what is happening on their website in terms of conversion rate optimization. Never ever take your customer for a ride. Never ever do that. This will not help you. You may actually get one customer, you may take them for a ride, then your business is doomed. You will not be called a good strategist, a good CRO strategist. Never ever do that. Never indulge in doing that. Never ever think of doing that. Deliver on promises. When we talk of interact and communicating with our clients, we do a lot of promises. We tell them that this is the traffic that I will drive to your website, this is the conversion that will happen to your website, and this is the business that you will get. You do a lot of promises, but promises have to be kept. Never ever promise anything that you cannot deliver. Stick to the promises and you will get more and more customers. More and more customers and more business for you. And you will be regarded as a very good CRO strategist. Promises have to be delivered and you need to deliver those promises that you make to your customers. Never ever promise anything that you cannot deliver. That will never happen. In conclusion, what we have seen in this video is who is a good CRO strategist, responsibilities of a good CRO strategist, skills of a good CRO strategist, and tips to be a good CRO strategist. Thank you so much for watching. Hope to see you again.